Every other Thursday, we're taking a look at a health issue or concern affecting many people, breaking down the information for you and telling you what you need to know to keep you healthy. Dr. Kalani Brady from the John A. Byrne School of Medicine joins us now with this week's topic, which is
leptospirosis.
Okay, very important because we've had some recent cases, so it's a good time to remind everyone about what it is, symptoms, and treatment. So first of all, what is it?
It's a rare bacterial illness. It's transmitted to humans on a rare basis from infected urine, which is deposited in the soil or in water by infected rodents, dogs, pigs, or other animals. And you can catch it by swimming in the water, by working in a loci where there are rats. You can catch it. The animals, of course, don't have to even be sick. They can be carriers of leptospirosis, but the humans generally get sick. In most cases, Christine, very fortunately, it's a rare disease and it has few symptoms. It feels a little bit like a mild flu and it goes away in a week. But in some cases, it can progress to meningitis and be fatal.
So who exactly is at risk for this?
Loci farmers and other farmers, hunters are at risk, sewer workers, swimmers in streams, like going up to Manoa Stream and swimming in the waterfalls. The military and veterinarians are all people that are at risk.
Now, you think a lot of others would be at risk because we're surrounded by water, but you say this is rare. Do we know how many cases a year usually pop up?
Very few.
Very few.
And of course, we've had recent cases in Hawaii, and that's probably because of the heavy rains we've had and the rains bringing the water down through the streams and contaminating people.
And what are the symptoms?
Symptoms are like a mild flu. There are symptoms in the serious cases, like a temperature up to 104 degrees, headaches, muscle aches, yellowing of the eyes, vomiting, diarrhea, and skin rash are all symptoms of severe leptospirosis.
So if these symptoms are similar to the flu, what should you do? At what point should you be concerned or talk to your doctor?
Well, first of all, if you've had the risk factor, if you've been exposed to a stream or a pool where that could be, or a loci kalo, a taro patch where that could be, then you suspect it if you have those symptoms, especially the high fever. A fever of 102 to 104 degrees, I would go in and see your doctor. It's easy. The doctor will examine you and then draw an antibody to leptospira. And if the antibody is positive, then of course you have the disease. And it's easily treated with penicillin and doxycycline, two very common antibiotics with very few side effects.
Okay, so that's good news.
It's great news, but you have to suspect it because otherwise it feels like the flu, it looks like the flu. The risk is that we just say, oh, it's just the flu, and we don't treat it.
If you don't treat it, what could happen?
Severe meningitis, kidney failure, pneumonia, or death even. It's very rare to die of leptospirosis, but it is known.
But it can happen, okay. And again, it is more prone, or we see more cases when we do have heavy rain, even though it is rare. Is there anything that people out there can do to prevent themselves from getting it if they have no choice but to work in these kind of situations, or if they are more at risk?
Sure. It's transmitted through openings in the skin. So if you have an open wound or a sore, then you should cover that sore with waterproof bandage. And similarly, if you're going to be tromping around in the jungle, you should cover your sores. That will help prevent it. In addition to that, avoid tromping around in the jungle. if it's heavy rains, avoid the heavy rain coming down through streams.
All right. There you have it. No tromping around.
No tromping around.
Thank you so much, Dr. Brady. Have a good weekend.
You too.